Jhana is not something negative. It's something very, very positive. It's pure, it is intense love for God. Intense love for God is tyaga. Tyaga is not giving up something, it's not something negative. Nobody can give up something without getting something higher. But what is this higher thing? It's not material. It's not material gain. It's something which is much beyond material, much beyond the emotional, much beyond the intellectual, our own self, real self. Because this is this daivi sampat that we have got. This divine treasure is our own true self. This divine treasure we are not bothered about. We have actually given up this divine treasure and we are after the material treasure. This is the whole problem. Swami Sri Ramakrishna says that Kamini Kanchana. So this Kamini Kanchana is what? It's nothing but all this Vishaya Bhoga, Vishaya Buddhi. Until we are able to come out of that, we will not be able to dedicate ourselves. So this 150th birth anniversary, all those who have been able to participate in it, do some seva for it, are really the blessed ones. All of you who have come here today for all these days, the Bhakta Sammelanam is going on, it's only because you could leave your own comfort zone. You could leave your own house, heart and home for these 4 days and come here and adjust with all the inconveniences that are there, like living in a camp, living a life of austerity and dedicating yourself for a higher cause. So all Swamiji's disciples, we find, they all came from such affluent background, the Western, the Eastern, everyone, all of them, they had given up everything for that great love of Swamiji. They had such an intense love for the Guru. As the scriptures say, Matri Deva Bhava, Pitri Deva Bhava, Acharya Deva Bhava, and Guru Deva Bhava. So, this Guru Deva Bhava, they had accepted Swamiji as the real Guru, the real God. For them, he was the prophet. The Westerners call him the prophet. So, this is what they had completely accepted and followed him till the last breath of the life. So, if we are able to dedicate ourselves to the service of Swamiji, we also would be able to make our life better. It's nothing but just giving up the Vijaya Buddhi. If we are able to give up the Vijaya Buddhi, we will be able to dedicate ourselves to the service of Swamiji. He didn't expect much, he didn't ask much from us. He did not ask much from us. He just said to love and serve. To love and serve. All of us, we cannot love and live without loving. And Sri Ramakrishna said today that people love so much for their family members. They try so much for their family members. But who cries for God? Who loves God? It's only when we get close, we start getting aware, that awareness comes. But before that, without that also, through the study of the scriptures, we should be able to get that awareness of what this Vishaya Buddhi is, what are the Vishayas, how this Panchabhutas are trying to enjoy the Panchabhutas through the senses. The whole thing comes there, that the Panchabhutas are trying to enjoy the Panchabhutas through the senses. So if we are able to control these, we will be able to dedicate ourselves just as the disciples of Swamiji had dedicated their lives to the service of Swamiji and feel blessed. So I am very grateful to all of you for giving me this opportunity to share a few ideas. It's not that we can go through the lives of each and one, every disciple or family, but the spirit that is there in all the disciples was the spirit of dedication, commitment, and complete surrender to the cause of Swami Jiva's mission. Thank you very much.
Namaskaram, Swami Chandrika Ji Maharaj.